to create your own resume for a cabin crew member. So let's begin with the first step, that is you only had to create an impression for like 6 seconds. It's hardly take a time, and there are a limited amount of time wherein the recruiter will actually see what or see or attract, and on the basis of that first impression your further procedures will be carried on. So the first impression has to be very impressive and long lasting in order to create an impactful image of yours in front of the recruiter. Further, now in order to create your CV, you should focus on the basic skills. And there are the basic skills mentioned here, which is customer service, teamwork, problem solving, communication skills, and achievements. Now, in order to write these skills, there should be some action verbs, which we, according to you and according to the recruiter, should be impactful enough so that it could impress, and the resume should be easy enough to read with a flow, and that doesn't end up baffling something about yourself and creating an exaggeration. So that we should, you have to use an appropriate word and verbs for that. So here are some examples where you can use some appropriate words in every skill while you're presenting or writing on a CV or a resume. For example, here's customer service skills. You can go with the verbs like advocated, assisted, displayed, mediated, resolved. Now further, next would be teamwork. Teamwork, you can say that I collaborated with this and this and end up coming with the wonderful results. And you can use encourage my team members, and we all, you know, get motivated, volunteered things, and came up with a work that impressed our team, impressed our recruiters or employers, and came up with the flying colors, and these all things which we can include. Then the problem solving, which would say like I formulated a policy which helped my team members and helped myself as well to come out of a situation and handle the, you know, a customer query or clarified the customer queries and problems. So these all things can be included. Further, the communication skills. In order to represent your communication skills, you can use the word like coordinator, develop, like if you are developing some skills, like you are being a part of a training session and in there wherein you are learning English, comprehensive English specifically. So you can include that. You can also include some competitions wherein you participated to, which enhanced actually your communication skills. Then the achievements. Achievements here in your resume play a very important role. So this section has to be very, very precise and, you know, attractive enough to just make the recruiter get in, indulge with this and recruit at that very moment. And let's now begin with the first step. This was just the introduction. Beginning with the first step would be you need to collate your details. Collate your details here means you have to actually accumulate all your details, and that detail should be accurate. That says you cannot just baffle around saying that I completed the work within 2 years or 3 years. You have to be sure enough that yes, you had an experience of like 2 years or 3 years or 10 years, whatever, from where you completed your education, what all are the works that you've been a part of, what all were the titles and the tenure of your employment period as well. Then your educational certificate should also be included with the proof. If you're mentioning something in your CV, always remember that there has to be certain proof for whatever you are writing in that. Next step would be formatting your resume. Now, formatting your resume means how you are arranging and customizing your resume, your template, your CV. So In order to format your resume, you have to strictly follow the template, which should not be, you know, vibrant enough so that the recruiter feels like you are just a kid of nursery, which actually wants the other person to be impressed by your vibrant and bright and bold resumes. The resume should be minimalistic enough that the recruiter feels a kind of, you know, proper relief and while reading it. And it should not be like, you know, so big and eyes tempting that the resume, that the recruiter feels like you are here for some, you are not serious enough for this interview. So be in a proper format and let that resume be minimalistic enough for recruitment. Then the next step is learn the requirements. It says if you are applying for a particular job and you know that what are the requirements, what all are the eligibility criteria that the recruiter is trying to find, and so you have to come up with that in your CV. So you have to first recognize what all qualities that the particular airlines is looking for, and then come write accordingly your resume. So here I just give an example that some airlines don't go with a lot of details about your qualities and competencies. They are just looking for like the includes. Airlines includes Emirates, Etihad, and Qatar. So that particularly focuses on your qualities, which are specifically mentioned in the sites, and you can go there and search it and then write your resume according to that. So every airline wants a different qualities. So according to that, do a proper research and then come up with your resumes. So here I have written down some qualities which should be included in a cabin crew application, and here are some specific qualities which specific airlines demands for. Like example, Emirates Airlines asks for a positive attitude from the employee and the one who has a friendly disposition, who is flexible enough and who upholds the values of the Emirates, which is like empathetic, progressive, professional, visionary. Now the Etihad specifically focuses on that it delivered a great service, like accurate time, and the values would be considered cultured, warm and generous, and which actually stands upon the customer expectations from that airline. And these are some basic qualities that I've listed down, and you can just give it a reading and you'll be able to know what all the cabin crew member has to be instilled itself. Now step four here is the style of your resume. The style of your resume here, in what way you are representing. The tone, the language, the style of your resume should be good enough that it is easy and in flow for the recruiter to read it. For example, if we start with a personal summary and then coming with the work experience, then writing down some voluntary work and then coming with the skills of yours. So this is the way where you can write down your resume properly, eliminate and also write everything in a past tense. This is quite important because you are at present giving the interview and everything that you have written here has done in past. So never forget that you have to write that thing in a past tense. So now the main attention that is to be given is to be on personal summary, which actually highlights your achievements and qualities and the work experience, which actually help the recruiter to know about your past experiences and your achievements in relation to that work experience of yours. Next step would be describe your achievements. So there, this is the most important part of your resume, where the recruiter actually looks for, and highlighting your achievements will actually make the recruiter know about you more. And a resume that you are writing should basically portray your skills and experiences you will bring and how will you fit in that airline. So you need to explain how you will exceed the exceptions, how will you be consistently delivering your best results and presenting yourself as the best candidate. So your achievements and accomplishments have to be very precise here, and which are, and not just you have to, you know, exaggerate here, you have to give the exact names and the achievements that you have achieved, because here the recruiter will look what the person from here you are from inside, how generous, how warm, how dealing with people, these all things matter. So achievements can be less, but that has to be proper, precise and honestly true. Okay, so moving forward, step 6 would be rechecking your resume. Rechecking or resume, that means going through that resume or that you made again and again, because every time you'll go through, you'll find some one or the other mistakes that you have done. Or it says that like nothing can be perfect, so there has to be someone one or the other mistakes. So you cannot just point out all the mistakes. You can make the resume the best way possible according to you, so that the other person looking recruiting you might feel like you have something in you and you are actually interested and willing to work here, with show some enthusiasm and highlight your basic skills and come up with a great words and qualities for the recruiter. Now here are some sites that I have listed down where you can just go and post your resume and just get on with a checker, where you can these sites will highlight some basic mistakes that might have done by every individual, so you can just go with that as well. Now the next come here is the cover letter for your resume. It is not necessary, first of all, to create a cover letter, but since nowadays all applications are being online, it is somewhere necessary. So, for example, some of the airlines asked for the cover letter, like Etihad Airways. They are obviously asked for the cover letter. Now, I have also given a cover letter format here, which includes that how you can present your cover letter for your resume. And here I have written down the format where you can see. Now first includes the introduction of yourself, then highlighting your knowledge, then achievements and skills, and then ending with a polite and a warm line. So here I just mentioned that I am very passionate about your airline and would strive to improve the brand and its success in everything I do. So this is a line that could actually make the recruiter very impressed from yours. The way you write, the way you speak, the way you present yourself is the thing that the people are looking for. So you can just follow this format and work accordingly on your resume and a cover letter. The next is, I'm just going to tell you about the interview questions. Once you are shortlisted for the interview, what are the questions that can be asked by the recruiter, and what are the answers that you can give from your side, the impressive answers. The first question comes here is, if you could change one thing on an airplane, what would it be? So that's a really, not the question that you will find in books. That is something you have to think with your own imagination, and you should be working. Imagine yourself working in a airplane, and what all, imagine yourself being as a customer, and what all things that you want to be improved on their part. So you can give the answer accordingly. Think it off and think of a realistic example and not just a too imaginary example, which is impossible for the other person to achieve. For example, here I have written that a flight Dubai, they have recently taken delivery of 737 MAX with an extended range that will allow the airline to fly to new destinations that are further afield. So the suggestion here can be given was that we can come up with a new delivery of the airplane and which can lead to new destinations and to fly at long distances basically. And the other example would be to start services between a particular place or between the particular cities. So here a given example is true for Qantas, who will start new services between Perth and Europe starting in 2018. So earlier that was not the route, but now we can suggest that since there are a lot of customers who want to travel and commute between these two places, so you can just suggest, and it's upon the recruiters and the members to look into suggestions or just go with the flow. So this is what you can answer here. The next question would be, what would you find most challenging about this role? That's a quite pretty, you know, question and frequent enough that you have to answer it very properly, because it is a thing that tells, that depicts about the knowledge that you have about that particular role. So you can just not go into much details, but the, you know, just the outline of what you think can be challenging enough. So first of all, you should have a quite knowledge of that role, enough knowledge, and what are your weaknesses and how you are going to challenge those weaknesses, how you're going to, you know, take the risk and overcome your personal challenges. And the last would be your commitment to the role. This is the most challenging task, that if you are committing something towards your profession, then you have to stick by it no matter what. That you have to be flexible enough and manage your time and manage your roles accordingly, so that you can challenge your weaknesses yourself and fulfill your commitment towards the contract that you sign and the role, provide full justification towards your role. So the next question would be, what is your biggest flaw? Since no one is perfect here, everybody has some or the other flaw or weakness in them. So never say to the recruiter that you are just perfect and you are not aware of any kind of flaw in yourself. But give a very, you know, good answer and just be truthful that you have this weakness here and you are working on that weakness. So just I've given an example here, like I used to think I wasn't a morning person and struggled to get out of bed to start work really early. Since you are in airlines, you have to be a person who is available when the recruiter says, like in the morning, there are airlines in the morning at 4, at 3, at 2, at 5. So now, since you're not a morning person, but in order to commit the role that you have assigned for, you have to become a morning person, you have to struggle, you have to wake up in the morning and come up at the work without any excuses. So this can be said. Here's another example as well. You can just go through it and read it and you will know how to answer this question. The next question would be, What are the most looking forward in this role? Right? What are your expectations basically from the role? And this is the question that basically every recruiter asks. So in order to put down your expectations from the role, you have to first of all again know all the benefits and all the details about your role that you've been provided with. And You can just think of the example, like you are, you know, willing to travel the world. So you are expecting that you will be traveling the world around, staying there, see, being able to explore and long hours. You're expected to work long hours there. So you have to, you know, make flexible enough according to yourself, your comfort level. And it's not always a such glamorous thing that it seems from outside. When one actually works there, it realizes that there is a lot of things that we have to do out of our comfort zone. So when you are asked with these things, that what are you expecting, you have to always say some good things and just say that you will be willing to extend at your limits in order to justify with your role that is provided. Then the next question would be, tell me about a time when you dealt with a high pressure situation. So everybody, since you have a lot of work experience with you, definitely you would be dealing with some high pressure situation somewhere or the other. So just point out that situation and use the SOAR method here. SOAR method means situation, objective, action, and result. So first of all, describe the situation that you've been through, then the objective that was actually to be fulfilled and was stuck in between. And then what is the action that you took? What was the, you know, policies or what all were the things that you have undertaken in order to get out of the situation? And what was the result at the end? Was it a positive result, a negative result, or you were including a team works? If you worked as a team, do specify that as you, I have worked as a team and my team members had supported me and we came up with this result at the end. Then this is the thing that you can do. And that's it for my presentation. There are many other questions asked, but these were the basic questions that that the recruiter can ask, and it's very frequent. So this is it. Thank you so much from my side. I hope that I have made myself clear enough. And so if you-